Ron Cerver, Director of Product Development and Program Manager for Li-ion Motors Corporation, on what it took for the Wave 2 to reach the next level of performance and safety standards to win an Automotive X Prize.
Yeah, there's a lot of the structure that you see, like the center console, under the upholstery actually there is steel crash bars. There is safety there. So from your frontal and rear impacts, a lot of that's going to be transmitted right through the middle of the car to the other end of the car. That's going to keep that passenger component in the same shape that it was before the crash. The same thing with the side impacts. There's a full steel roll bar in this, but also the composite skeleton of this car has borders and beams built right into it to actually withstand some of the side impact, and it helps to bring the forces around the passenger compartment and transfers them to the other side of the vehicle instead of through the center of them.
Now how about comfort? Because these seats don't look like they have a lot of cushion to
this
them.
This is still set up basically what the seats that we're in for the X Prize. So we had just some basic seats that we could put in there. We actually have full reclining seats, all adjustable, nice ventilated seats actually go in these cars. But for the X Prize, we just needed the basic stuff, but we wanted some additional safety as well because we are running on the racetracks and we are running with other cars in a performance and a type of competition where something could happen, you know.
Absolutely. Now, how about the airbags? Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
Well, we have airbags, but once again, for the X Prize, they can't be armed because of the type of competition it was. You know, there was a lot of cars spinning out. There was a lot of cars. I mean, they really stressed these cars to the limit of what they could do. We had to go out there and go on a 300-foot skid pad, and we had to get to at least a 0.7 G's on the skid pad, which is a base number of what any street car is supposed to be able to do. So we surpassed that by quite a bit, but we did see cars spinning out on those type of events. We had to do a lane change maneuver, such as somebody stepping off of the curb and you need to immediately change lanes and change back. Well, that was something that they'd set up with cones and everything. Exact amount of feet, it was metered for your exact speeds. We had the consumer division came in and the same people that test today's cars for every manufacturer tested all of our stuff as well. So all the same equipment, all the same distances, and we had to pass it. We had to do 0 to 60 performance tests. We had to do 60 to 0 braking tests. So everything that today's car had to pass, we had to pass those in order to move on to the next level in the X Prize as well.